I can't remember when you were there.
Finished in 1929, 1 week prior to the start of the Great Depression, the arena was built on Oakland Avenue. At first, the arena would host dairy shows, but eventually, when a concrete floor was added, the old barn began hosting the circus, concerts, even Cub Scout jamborees. The building came into its own in 1967 when the Solomon family brought an NHL franchise to the city, the St. Louis Blues. The Blues were an instant fit at the old arena, and although they made the Stanley Cup Finals in each of their first three seasons, the game the Blues fans will remember forever happened on May 12, 1986, the Monday Night Miracle.
Puderko steals the puck from Reinhardt. Over to Hunter, who shoots, block. Wickenheiser scores! Doug Wickenheiser! The Blues pull it off, and it's unbelievable! There'll be a seventh game.
I remember going out of the locker room, probably 45 minutes, an hour later, there were still people standing in the stands cheering and clapping. They didn't want to leave the building.
That was clearly one of the most astonishing comebacks anyone will ever see in any sport.
And those are moments that you know, still send chills up and down my spine, because it was part of history that the Blues will always remember.
It was common for the Blues to play in front of a sellout crowd in the early 90s, and when they moved here to the Kiel Center in 95, they could play in front of roughly 21,000 fans. However, back in the mid-80s, back at the arena, it was a different St. Louis team that rocked the house.
The Blues shared the arena with the St. Louis Steamers, a team so popular in the 80s, they set and still hold the national indoor attendance record for a soccer game with just over 17,000 fans, which they set for the 1981-82 season. Fans at the arena on March 27th, 1981, saw the Steamers play their best game ever.
The most memorable moment was we played Wichita in a semifinal game, and we're down 6-1 with 7 minutes left in the game, and we came back and tied it.
Now we're down to 1-13. Ty Keel goes into Donnie Ebert, and the Steve Putcher misses, and they scored. Donnie Ebert has tied the game.
And I know people talk about how rocking it's been for Blues games and concerts and this and that, but I have never, ever heard that, heard the arena as loud as it was that night.
Basketball also had its moments in the old barn. In 1973, Bill Walton and the UCLA Bruins faced the Memphis Tigers in the championship game. Walton had one of the greatest individual performances ever, hitting 21 of 22 shots, scoring 44 points, and giving UCLA the national championship. But arguably the best basketball game ever played at the old barn was the last one, the Border War of 1993, pitting Mizzou against the Illini. The game was decided in triple overtime, and the Tigers won it, 108-107.
Bush Brangenreich's trophy. Again, it belongs to the Tigers.
There are places I remember all my life, though some have changed, some forever, not for better. Some have gone, and some remain.